But it was Mazda that pushed the most concise vision of the automotive future. In line with the New York show's environmental theme and the Big Apple's increasingly crowded streets, Mazda introduced the AZ-1 to the American public. This tiny two-seater proves that being small and fuel-efficient doesn't mean you have to be dull. Its mid-mounted 660cc turbocharged three-cylinder engine pulls around an all-plastic body that still includes such up-to-date safety equipment as anti-lock brakes. Mazda thinks the AZ-1's gull-wing doors make sense for city dwellers since they take up less space to open. Openness is also the idea behind the mostly glass roof. We were so taken with the AZ-1 that we've asked Mazda to let us do a more thorough test on it soon.
Now for some great new car information, let's turn to Lisa Barrow. She has all the latest motor news. Lisa?
A few weeks back, John, we promised our viewers a better look at Mazda's micro mini car, the AZ-1. Its visit here at Motorweek was brief, but it attracted lots of attention everywhere we went. At less than 11 feet long, 55 inches wide, and 45 inches high, the AZ-1 is the perfect vehicle for maneuvering in traffic, especially on crowded Japanese streets where smaller is better. The wedge-shaped coupe has been on sale since September in Japan, where it's Mazda's latest entry in the highly competitive K-Class for micro-mini cars. The AZ-1's gull-wing doors allow parking in closer quarters and contain side impact bars. Other safety features include large side sills, an ample crash zone, impact-absorbing steering wheel, and a sturdy upper body structure. The AZ-1's styling is reminiscent of other mid-engine cars, but all of its body panels are made of recyclable plastics. Power comes from this dual overhead cam turbocharged three-cylinder engine with four valves per cylinder from Mazda's Japan-only four-door micro-mini, the Autozam Carol. Its 660cc size and 64 horsepower are the prescribed limits for K-car class power plants. But don't let the AZ-1's diminutive size fool you. It has no trouble keeping up with or passing traffic, thanks in part to the 5-speed manual transmission delivering maximum torque to the rear wheels at only 4,000 RPM. Well below the engine's 9,000 RPM red line. Interior space for the driver and one passenger is more generous than you'd expect, even for six-footers, such as our coordinating producer. And though he towers over the AZ-1 in non-driving situations, it's similar in size to some of his other vehicles and drew admiring glances from drivers of all ages. The clear canopy-like roof created by the gull-wing doors ensures a feeling of openness inside the cabin. Inside the AZ-1, we had to get comfortable sitting on the right side, as in England and Japan, and shifting gears with our left hand. But once we'd gotten the hang of it, driving the AZ-1 was easy. It's handling firm and secure. And though we never forgot how really small it was, we always felt in control, no matter what the driving conditions were. Mazda brought this lone AZ-1 to the New York Auto Show to get reactions from American drivers. Our drivers thought it very competent and a lot of fun. The company expects to sell 800 per month in Japan, and while there are no current plans to import the car to the U.S., John, should demand for really small cars increase, Mazda could be ahead of the competition.